The chapter within an exchange of gases. We already discussed about definition of breathing. Then types of respiration, then external respiration, internal respiration, cellular respiration, and also we discuss about the what type of respiration seen in all organisms like fish and arthropods, molluscs, amphibians like that. Okay, next we also discuss about the human respiratory system. Then in that structure of respiratory systems are there. First one is nasal cavity, next one is pharynx, larynx, trachea, primary bronchi, lungs, and bronchial tree. Okay, already we know that what is nasal cavity, what are the functions of that nasal cavity, and pharynx, larynx, and trachea. Today we are going to study trachea. Okay, trachea is a straight tube extending up to the mid thoracic cavity, which divides at the level of fifth thoracic vertebra into a right and left primary bronchi. Okay, first we know about what is trachea, where it is present. Just observe this structure. This one is the epiglottis. Next to the epiglottis, there is a larynx, nothing but a sound box. Okay. Below the sound box, there is a cylindrical elongated tube-like structure is present. That is known as the trachea. Okay. Trachea, it is commonly known as the windpipe. Okay. It is lined by a pseudo stratified mucus secreting ciliated epithelium. Okay, it is lined by pseudo stratified mucus secreting ciliated epithelium. Okay, what is the function of this ciliated mucus secreting ciliated epithelium? It traps the dust particles present in inhaling of the air. Okay, understood. Next, it is lined by C shaped cartilaginous rings. These are the cartilaginous rings. Those are present in trachea. Okay, these are important characteristic features of the trachea. Okay, next. This one is the okay. See, this one is the trachea, elongated is the trachea, elongated tube-like structure. It is lined by C-shaped structures. These are lined by C-shaped structures. those are called as cartilaginous rings. Cartilaginous rings. Okay. Trachea, it is a commonly known as the windpipe lined by a pseudo stratified mucus secreting ciliated epithelium. Okay, it is lined by a C-shaped cartilaginous rings. Okay, the function of trachea is they trap that mucus secreting ciliated epithelium traps the dust particles present in the inhaling of the air. Okay, next one important part, that is called as primary bronchi. Primary bronchi, it is okay. Next one is primary bronchi. I'm audible. Okay, next one is the important part, it is called as primary bronchi. Primary bronchi, it is present below the trachea. Okay, when the trachea, it is ends up to the fifth thoracic region, then it will be divided. Okay, divided and enter into the lungs. Okay, it is called as primary bronchi. Okay, primary bronchi, trachea divides into left and right primary bronchi that entering into the left and right lungs respectively. Okay, this one is the primary bronchi. Okay, the trachea divides and enters into the lungs. Okay, left and right lungs. Okay, below the trachea, the primary bronchi is divided and enters to the left and right lungs. Okay, next one is important structure, that is called as lung. Lungs. Okay, what are lungs? Have you heard the term lungs? Where they present? Lungs are spongy, elastic, and triangular structures. Okay. Where they present? Where they located? How many numbers of lungs are there? Okay, only one pair of lungs are there. Nothing but two lungs are there. One is left lung, another one is the right lung. In case of human being, the respiration occurs with the help of lungs. That's why we call the term pulmonary respiration. Pulmonary respiration, it takes place only in human beings. What is pulmonary respiration? The respiration occurs with the help of lungs. Okay, lungs are the spongy, elastic, triangular structures. In case of human being, pulmonary respiration will seen. Okay, what is pulmonary respiration? Respiration occurs with the help of lungs. Okay, in case of human being, one pair of lungs are present. Where they located? Location. Okay, they are well protected. Lungs are well protected in thoracic cavity. Okay, what is thoracic cavity? Where it is present? Okay, thoracic cavity have a four sides. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಸೈಡ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಥೊರಾಸಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾವಿಟಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಫ್ರಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಬೋನ್, ರೀಜನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಥೊರಾಸಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾವಿಟಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಬಹುದು ಓಕೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇಂಟು 4 ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸರೌಂಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ 4 ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದು ಅರೌಂಡ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅದು ಥೊರಾಸಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾವಿಟಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಟರ್ನಮ್ ಓಕೆ ಸ್ಟರ್ನಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ವೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಬಾಡಿ ದೆನ್ ವರ್ಟಿಬ್ರಲ್ ಕಾಲಮನ್ ವರ್ಟಿಬ್ರಲ್ ಕಾಲಮನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ಡಾರ್ಸಲ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಸ್ಟರ್ನಮ್ ಥೊರಾಸಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾವಿಟಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಥೊರಾಸಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾವಿಟಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ್ದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಟರ್ನಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ವೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಬಾಡಿ ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ವರ್ಟಿಬ್ರಲ್ ಕಾಲಮನ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ವಿ ನೋ ಅಬೌಟ್ ವರ್ಟಿಬ್ರಲ್ ಕಾಲಮನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಡಾರ್ಸಲ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಬಾಡಿ ಓಕೆ ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರಿಬ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಲ್ಯಾಟ್ರಲ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಓಕೆ 12 ಪೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಬ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ ದೆನ್ ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡಯಾಫ್ರಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಲೋಯರ್ ಎಂಡ್ ಓಕೆ ಅತ್ತ ಲೋಯರ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ ಡಯಾಫ್ರಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಫೋರ್ ಸರೌಂಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಥೊರಾಸಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾವಿಟಿ ಓಕೆ ಡಯಾಫ್ರಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ನೋ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಡಯಾಫ್ರಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಓಕೆ ಇಟ್ ಸಪರೇಟ್ಸ್ ಡಯಾಫ್ರಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಸಪರೇಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಅಪ್ಪರ್ ಥೊರಾಸಿಕ್ ಟು ದ ಅಬ್ಡಾಮಿನಲ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಅಪ್ಪರ್ ಥೊರಾಸಿಕ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಬ್ಡಾಮಿನಲ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಇದು ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಯಾವುದು ಡಯಾಫ್ರಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಓಕೆ Just observe this diagram. Okay, this one, these are the lungs. Okay, these are the lungs. Two lungs are there. Okay, these are surround. These are present at the thoracic cavity. Okay, thoracic cavity means it is lined by four regions. One is sternum. It is present at the ventral region. Another one is the vertebral column. This is present at the dorsal surface. And other one is the ribs. Ribs are present at the lateral side. Then a diaphragm. This one is a diaphragm. It is present below the lungs. This one is the diaphragm. Okay, diaphragm. It separates the upper thoracic. This region is called as upper thoracic. Upper thoracic. Below the diaphragm, there is a abdomen is present. Okay, it separates diaphragm. It separates the upper. Thoracic cavity and abdomen. Okay, it's called as diaphragm. Okay. Here, just observe the structure of the lungs. Lungs are already we know about spongy, elastic, and triangular in shape. Okay. Then these are lined by two layers. Lungs are lined by two layers. Two layers. One is the two membranes are present at the surface of the lungs okay one is the outermost layer it is called as visceral pleura visceral pleura next innermost layer called as parietal pleura okay parietal pleura lungs are surrounded by two layers that is outermost layer called as visceral pleura then innermost layer called as parietal pleura okay the lungs are enclosed by two membranes those are called as pleural membranes those are called as pleural membrane pleural membrane is divided into outer and inner layer outer layer is called as visceral pleura it is present at the thoracic region okay next another one innermost layer called as parietal pleura it is present at the lung surface it is near to lung surface it is near to lung surface andre ee nodi illi idu visceral pleura it is near to thoracic region ಓಕೆ ಔಟರ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಇನ್ನರ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಿಯರ್ ಟು ಲಂಗ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಲಂಗ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ಗೆ ನಿಯರ್ ಇದೆ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಔಟರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ನರ್ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ there is a one cavity is present. There is a narrow space present in between the outer and inner membrane. That is called as pleural cavity. The in between, that there is a narrow space present inside the outer and inner membrane. That is called as pleural cavity. Pleural cavity. Okay, pleural cavity. It is the narrow space present in between outer and inner membrane. Okay, this is regarding about the outer coverings of the lungs. Okay, next, this pleural cavity, the narrow space that is present in between the outer and inner membrane, there is a hollow space or narrow space is present, that is called as pleural cavity. This pleural cavity filled with the pleural fluid. Okay, the pleural fluid, it is present inside the pleural cavity. Okay, what is the function of this pleural fluid? Pleural fluid, it acts as a lubricant. It acts as a lubricant. Okay, while breathing, okay, it reduces the friction. While breathing, it reduces the friction in between the two membranes. It reduces the frictions in between the two membranes. Nothing but the visceral pleura and parietal pleura nadave eno frictions agre irutara iden madutte at the time of breathing iden madutte avoid madutte. It acts as a lubricant. Diagram is important, students. Mark it and take. Diagram is important. Okay. Next, we are more towards the differences between left and right lung. Okay, left and right lung. Now, differences. Ena na kanti dana nimge idrali eradu onde tara idana. Both are similar. Left and right lungs are both are similar. Just observe it. Okay, here right lung is bigger. Right lung is bigger and wider. Right lung is bigger, wider, long. Bigger, wider, and long. Okay, right lung, it is reduced by 2.5 centimeter. Okay, next, another one, left lung. Compared to right lung, left lung is smaller, narrow, and short. Compared to right lung, left lung is smaller, narrow, and short. Okay, yaake short agirutte, yaake short agirutte left lung? Because the presence of small depression. The small depression is present near to the left lung. Okay, that is called as cardiac knots. Cardiac knots. Cardiac knots means the presence of heart near to the left lung. That's why it is smaller in nature. Okay, then what are the differences? The right lung is bigger, wider, and long. It is reduced by 2 centimeter. Okay, next one is the left lung. Left lung, it is smaller. It is smaller, narrow, and short due to the presence of small depression. Okay, near to left lung, the depression is called as cardiac knots. Okay, cardiac knot is nothing but the presence of heart. Okay, near to left lung. That's why it is smaller in nature. Okay, next, just observe this tree like tree branches like structures. Okay, this tree branches like structures. Okay, those are already we discussed primary bronchi. Primary bronchi, it is divided. Primary bronchi, that ena trachea inda eno trachea divide agutalva, ee trachea inda barodella yadu primary bronchi agirutte. It enters to the eno lungs, left and right lung. Then this primary bronchi will be divided, subdivided into secondary bronchi. this the primary bronchi divided into secondary bronchi, then secondary bronchi divided into tertiary bronchi. Okay, then secondary bronchi divided into tertiary bronchi. Okay, tertiary bronchi, secondary bronchi, primary bronchi divided into what? This one is the primary bronchi. Okay, just listen, this one is the primary bronchi, primary bronchi divided into secondary bronchi, then secondary bronchi divided into tertiary bronchi. Okay, these are commonly known as the bronchioles. These are known as the bronchioles anta heltivi, bronchioles. Okay, each bronchiole is ended with the grape like structures. Okay, those are called as grape like structures. Okay, those are called as alveoli. Important term, alveoli. Alveoli, these are the grape like structures, alveoli. Okay, alveoli are the grape like structures. Those are present at the last region of the bronchiole. Okay, these are called as the alveoli. Alveoli are the structural, it is one mark question. Alveoli are the structural functional unit of respiratory system. Okay, what are the alveoli? Alveoli are the structural functional unit of respiratory system. Okay, structural functional unit of respiratory system. Okay, next, which connects this alveoli, which connects the pulmonary artery. Alveoli connect the pulmonary artery that carries deoxygenated blood, which connects pulmonary artery that carries deoxygenated blood. Okay, next, again it connects to the another side, pulmonary vein. Pulmonary vein that carries oxygenated blood. Don't confuse, alveoli are present at the end of the bronchioles, tertiary bronchioles. These are the grape like structures. Then these are the structural and functional unit of respiratory system. Then they are connected, these alveoli are connected pulmonary artery that carries deoxygenated blood, and again it again connect with the pulmonary veins that carries oxygenated blood. Okay, alveoli that connects the pulmonary artery and pulmonary veins. Okay, this is regarding the structure of the lungs. Okay, these are the important characteristics of the lungs. Lungs are, one pair of lungs are present in human. These are elastic, spongy, elastic and triangular in shape, and triangular in shape. Again, I am repeating about lungs. Okay, about lungs. Okay, lungs are spongy, elastic and triangular in nature. Okay, in case of human being, pulmonary respiration takes place. Pulmonary respiration means the respiration occurs with the help of lungs. Okay, pulmonary respiration means the respiration occurs with the help of lungs. Okay, one pair of lungs are present, that means two lungs are present. One is left lung, another one is the right lung. Okay, then location, where it is present, it is well protected. Lung is well protected in thoracic cavity. Okay, it is present at the breast bone. Okay, then it is surrounded by four types of structure, that is called as, those are called as sternum. Sternum present at the ventral side. Sternum present at the ventral side. Vertebral column present at the dorsal side. Ribs are present at the lateral side, and 12 pair of ribs are present. Okay, then another one is the diaphragm. Diaphragm that separates the upper thoracic to the abdominal cavity. Okay, next, lungs are enclosed by two membranes. Those are called as pleural membranes. Okay, it is lined by two types of membrane. Those are inner membrane is called as visceral pleura. then outer membrane is called as parietal pleura. Okay, parietal pleura, it is near to the lung surface, and the thoracic visceral pleura, it is present at the thoracic. Okay, inner membrane called as visceral. Okay, inner membrane called as visceral. Okay, outer membrane called as parietal. Okay, there is a narrow space in between the upper, in between the inner and outer membrane, that is called as a pleural cavity. This pleural cavity filled with the pleural fluid, it acts as a lubricant. Okay, it reduces the friction while breathing. It reduces the friction, two membranes against each other during the breathing. Okay, ena rub aagtidre, rubbing each other aagtirutte, breathing aagbekare eradu membrane irutala rub aagtirutte, adana avoid madodike rubbing nadithirutte process, adana avoid madod, adana avoid madutte yavdu idu fluid, pleural fluid. Okay, then we discuss about the differences. What are the differences are there left and right lung? Okay, right lung is bigger, wider, long. Okay, it is reduced by the size 2.5 cm. Then left lung is smaller, narrow, short in nature. Okay, then there is a cardiac notch is present near to the left lung. Okay, these again the structures are present, tree like tree branches like structures are present. Those are contain blood capillaries and tubes. Okay, these are called as bronchioles. Okay, here the primary bronchi divided into secondary bronchi divided into tertiary bronchi. At the end of the bronchiole there is a grape like structure is present, that is called as alveoli. Alveoli are the structural and functional unit of respiratory system. Okay, then these are connected with pulmonary artery and pulmonary vein. This is regarding about the structure of lungs. Okay, understood? Okay, next we will discuss about the mechanism of respiration. Now we discuss about the structure of the respiratory system. Already we know about nasal cavity, larynx, pharynx, lungs, bronchioles. Okay, these are next. We are moving towards the next topic, important one. Important one. Mechanism of respiration. Mechanism of respiration. Next subheading, mechanism of respiration. Okay, mechanism of respiration, it is very complex process. It is a complex process. Mechanism of respiration is a complex process. It is takes place by five different steps. It is takes place by five different steps. It is takes place by five different steps. First one is the breathing. First one is the breathing or pulmonary ventilation. First one is the breathing. First one mechanism yavudu, first one step yavudu, idralli mechanism of respiration alli first one to breathing or pulmonary ventilation. Okay, next one to diffusion of the gases. Next one to diffusion of the gases. Diffusion, already we know about diffusion. What is diffusion? What is diffusion? What is diffusion? What is diffusion? Diffusion means the movement of the transport of gas from higher concentration to the lower concentration region. Okay, diffusion of gases between alveoli. Diffusion means is diffusion of gases across the alveolar membrane. Okay, already we discussed about the alveoli and how they connect with the heart. Okay, next, alveolar membrane, diffusion of the gases between alveoli and blood. Alveoli and blood. Next one is the next step is transport of gases. 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 Next one, Fourth one, diffusion of gases between, diffusion of gases between blood and tissues. Here the diffusion of gases between alveoli and blood. Alveoli and blood. Okay, this one is the diffusion of the gases. Gases nothing but oxygen and carbon dioxide. Okay, the diffusion of the gases between blood and tissues. Okay, last one step. Okay, utilization of oxygen. Last one is the utilization of oxygen by the cells. Okay, for catabolic reaction. Respiration is a catabolic reaction. Yes or no? Okay, catabolic reactions. Okay, then these are the mechanisms of respiration. Mechanism of respiration. Respiration is a complex process. It is done by 5 different steps. First one is breathing or pulmonary ventilation. Next one is the diffusion of gases between alveoli, and blood. Okay, between alveoli blood, alveoli level anta karithivi. Okay, next one is the transport of gases. Next one to diffusion of oxygen or nothing but the diffusion of gases between blood and body tissues. Next, last step is utilization of oxygen. Okay, first one we discussed about breathing and pulmonary ventilation. Already we know about the definition of breathing. Yes or no? What? Okay, tell me, anyone tell me the definition of breathing. Okay, it is a process of intake of fresh air. Nothing but oxygen. Fresh air, nothing but water. Oxygen and release of foul air. Nothing but carbon dioxide is rich in nature. Okay. Breathing or pulmonary ventilation means, okay, intake of fresh air and release of foul air. Okay, fresh air nothing but oxygen, foul air nothing but carbon dioxide. Okay, Satvik correct, giving out the carbon dioxide. Okay, next, in this process it is divided into two types. It is intake of oxygen and exhale of carbon dioxide. Okay, Angel Soumya, very good. Next, it is done by two stages. Breathing takes place by two stages, two different types. First one is inspiration. Breathing takes place by two steps. First one is inspiration or inhalation. Next one is expiration or exhalation. Okay, these are the two steps comes under breathing. Okay, first one we discuss about inhalation or inspiration. It is a process in which atmospheric air, the movement of air from the atmosphere into the lungs, Okay, where it is?